महाकाय सूर्यकोटि समप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा।
Discuss the basis of reaction mechanism of organic chemistry by using the concepts of acids and bases. It is very important for the plus two syllabus, 11th, 12th syllabus, and for entrance syllabus also. Okay. Concepts of acids and bases. To understand the basis of reaction mechanism of organic chemistry. Okay, first concept, RNAS concept. First concept is the Arrhenius concept. Acid H plus donor in water H2O plus H plus is equal to H3O plus, that is hydronium ion donor. Base OH minus donor. OH minus donor. Generally strong acids and strong bases which undergo complete ionization at a particular dilution, means particular amount of water. Generally strong acids and strong bases which undergo complete ionization at a particular dilution belong to this class, belong to this Arrhenius class. Generally strong acids and strong bases means which undergo complete ionization at a particular dilution belong to Arrhenius plus. Okay, strong acids. Strong acids. HClO4. Perchloric acid. H2SO4. H3PON. H3PO4 phosphoric acid, H3PO3 phosphorus acid, etc. HNO3. Halo acid, except HF. HF is a weak acid. It is not a strong acid. Okay. These are the common examples of strong acids. Strong bases. Strong bases. NaOH, KOH, RBOH, CSOH, BAOH hold twice, SROH hold twice, CAOH hold twice, etc. These are the examples of strong acids and strong bases, which undergo complete ionization at a particular dilution, and they belong to Arrhenius class. Okay. One example. Let's consider ionization of HCl in water. Acid results H plus, in water it is H3O plus and Cl minus. HCl undergoes complete ionization. Ionization of HF in water. HF in water. H3O plus, F minus, and HF. Because some amount of HF undergoes ionization and some amount of HF is left behind. Okay. Another concept. Bronsted, Lowry concept. Bronsted, Lowry concept, also called protonic concept, based on proton. Acid H plus donor, base H plus acceptor, base H plus acceptor. Acid minus H plus is equal to conjugate base of that acid. Okay. For example, HCl minus H plus is equal to Cl minus. It is the conjugate base of acid HCl. Acid HCl. Similarly, base plus H plus conjugate acid of that base. Cl minus plus H plus is equal to HCl. It is the conjugate acid of base Cl minus. Okay. Bronsted concept is based on proton. Acid H plus donor, base H plus acceptor. Acid minus H plus, conjugate base of that acid. Base plus H plus, conjugate acid of that base. Notebook. Strong acid results weak conjugate base and weak conjugate base has weaker proton affinity. For example, acidic strength. HCl a strong acid, HF a weak acid, all organic acids are weak acid, all organic acids are weak acid. Conjugate basic strength or proton affinity strength Cl minus less than F minus less than CH3 CO minus. Strong acid results weak conjugate base and weak conjugate base has weaker proton affinity. Okay. Then Lewis concept called electronic concept based on electron. Lewis acid can accept at least one electron pair. That electron pair may be a lone pair or non-bonding pair, pi electron pair, sigma electron pair, etc. Okay. Lewis base can donate at least one electron pair okay. According to Ingold, Lewis acids are also called electrophiles, E plus, electron loving, and Lewis bases are also called nucleophiles, nucleus loving. Lewis acids are also called electrophiles, E plus, and Lewis bases are also called nucleophiles, Nu minus. Okay. Examples of E plus electrophiles. Examples of E plus electrophiles. A. Cations like Cu2+, Mg2+, Na+, Ag+, Al3+, etc. Notebook, but not H3O+, NH4+ type, because they are Bronsted acids or protonic acids. They can donate proton but cannot attract electron. Okay, how? H3O+ minus H+, water is possible, which is the conjugate base of acid H3O+. H3O+ plus electron H3O, and it is not possible. It is possible. It means Bronsted reaction is possible, but Lewis reaction is not possible, as H3O does not exist. Okay. B. Molecules having incomplete octet or electron deficit center. Incomplete octet or electron deficit center. Example, BH3 called borane, B2H6 called diborane, dimer of BH3. Okay, then BCl3, then BeCl2, H3BO3, AlCl3, etc. They have incomplete octet or electron deficit center. Electron deficit center. Okay. How? Boron, helium, 2s2, 2px1, 2py0, 2pz0. It is the ground state based on Horn's rule. Actually, it is helium 2s2, 2p1, and based on Horn's rule, it is 2px1, 2py0, and 2pz0, because 2p subshell has 3 orbitals x, y, and z. Okay, in ground state. If required, we can explain the excited state. It is the excited state. 3 unpaired electron for covalent bonding. Because sharing of unpaired electrons explain covalent bonding. Even it has vacant 2pz orbital. And octet is not justified even after covalent bonding. After covalent bonding, it becomes 2s2, 2px2, 2py2. Valence shell contains 6 electrons. Means it has incomplete octet and it has vacant 2pz orbital, which can attract an electron pair to complete the octet. Hence, it is a Lewis acid. Okay. C. Presence of vacant d orbitals at center. Presence of vacant d orbitals at center. Example, SiCl4, silicon has vacant d orbital. AlCl3 also. Aluminium belongs to incomplete octet category. Aluminium belongs to vacant d orbital category also. Okay. FeCl3. CuCl2. PCl5, etc. How? Silicon, neon, 3s2, 3px1, 3py1, 3pz0 in ground state. And 3d0 in valence shell. 3d vacant orbitals are there. Excited state, because it has only two unpaired electron, but in order to result SiCl4 it requires four unpaired electron. Hence the excited state of silicon is 3s1, 3px1, 3py1, 3pz1, 3d0 for covalent bonding. For covalent bonding, vacant orbitals to attract electron pair. Okay, it is the excited state. Okay, now in excited state, silicon results SiCl4 by using 1s and 3p. Hence the hybridization is sp3. By gaining 2cl- it becomes SiCl6 2-. By using sp3 d2 hybridization, because two vacant 3d orbitals are used to explain SiCl6 2-. Here SiCl4 is the Lewis acid and Cl- is the Lewis base, which can donate electron pair to the Lewis acid SiCl4. Okay. Similarly, AlCl3 hybridization is sp2, and it has vacant 3pz, like 2pz in boron, 3pz vacant in aluminium. Okay. AlCl4- sp3 hybridization. Okay. It is due to incomplete octet. Plus 2cl- AlCl6 3-, it is due to the presence of vacant d orbital. Okay. Silicon does not have incomplete octet in excited state. Hence the hybridization is sp3. By using the vacant d orbitals, SiCl6 2- is possible. Okay. AlCl3 has vacant 3pz, it has incomplete octet. To complete the octet, it becomes sp3 hybridized, and by using the vacant d orbitals, it becomes sp3 d2 hybridized. Okay, notebook. In aluminium group, boron is there. BCl6 3-. In silicon group, carbon is there. CCl6 2- are not possible, as boron carbon don't have vacant 2d orbitals. Okay. BCl3 sp2 hybridization like LCl3, and it has vacant to pz. By using this vacant 2pz orbital, it can attract an electron pair from the Lewis base Cl minus to become BCl4 minus, and it has sp3 hybridization. And as it has no vacant d orbital, we cannot expand the valency further like aluminium, because the valency of the aluminium can be extended. Now the valency of the boron cannot be extended, as boron does not have vacant d orbital. Okay, multiple bond means double and triple, not single. Okay, multiple bond with more electronegative atoms, also explain electrophilic nature. Example, carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, SO2. Okay, in organic chemistry, carbonyl compounds, that is aldehydes and ketones, because aldehyde and ketones have common carbonyl group. Okay, then carboxylic acids and derivatives, cyanide, etc. Multiple bond with more electronegative atoms. Okay, this more electronegative atom can attract electron from the central atom in multiple way, so that the central atom becomes more electron deficit, to explain more electrophilic nature. Okay, then examples of Lewis bases or nucleophiles. A. All anions. All cations except NH4 plus H3O plus kind. Similarly, here all anions. B. Lone pair or non-bonding electron pair at center in octet state, NH3, water, amine in organic chemistry, alcohol in organic chemistry, ether in organic chemistry, secondary amine in organic chemistry, etc. at octet state. Okay, C. Unsaturated compounds, that is organic compounds having C double bond C and C triple bond C. Okay, example, alkenes, alkynes, benzene, etc. They have also multiple bond, but not with more electronegative atoms. Hence, they are nucleophiles. If it is C double bond O or C triple bond N, then these are the examples of the electrophiles. Okay, these are the examples of the nucleophiles. Okay. Now we are going to discuss the basis of reaction mechanism. Okay. To understand the reaction mechanism in organic chemistry, we should use the concepts of acids and bases, and we also should use some basic concepts called inductive effect and electromagnetic effect. It is also very simple. Okay. Notebook. Inductive effect. Inductive effect means displacement of sigma electron cloud. Displacement of sigma electron cloud towards the more electronegative atom, and it is explained in single bonded system in organic chemistry. R plus Cl minus, displacement of sigma electron cloud towards more electronegative atom to explain bond polarity. Bond polarity means bond ionization. Bond ionization. Okay. Another one. Electromeric effect. Electromeric effect. It is generally explained in multiple bonded system. It is generally explained in multiple bonded system. Okay. Displacement of pi electron cloud. Sigma 1, pi 1. Displacement of loosely held bond, that is pi 1. Displacement of pi 1 to explain bond polarization is called electromeric effect. Displacement of pi electron cloud to explain bond polarity is called electromeric effect. Okay. Then inductive effect is a permanent effect means spontaneous effect means self-driven effect. Okay. Inductive effect is a permanent effect, that is self-driven. Electromeric effect is a temporary effect. Is a temporary effect. Okay. It means non spontaneous effect. It is not self-driven. It is driven by some deforming force or by some important organic reagents. Okay. Temporary effect. And you should remember that permanent effect dominates over temporary effect in the reaction mechanism in organic chemistry. Hence, inductive effect explains greater bond polarity. Greater bond polarity. Okay. Due to this, inductive effect dominates over electromeric effect to explain the reaction mechanism. Okay. For example, it is very interesting. It is carboxylic acid. If this bond is broken, it is an example of inductive effect, sigma bond. Inductive effect. Okay. R1. Okay. R is the rate of reaction for the reaction mechanism. If this bond is broken by the help of pi bond, then it is an example of electromeric effect. R2 is the rate of participation of the pi bond for reaction mechanism. R1 is the rate of participation of sigma bond for reaction mechanism. And it is very interesting that R1 greater than R2. It means OH C bond OH cleavage takes place at a faster rate to explain the reaction mechanism than breaking of pi bond to explain the reaction mechanism. Okay. Inductive effect dominates over electromeric effect, as inductive effect is a permanent effect or self-driven effect, and electromeric effect is a temporary effect, or it is not self-driven, it is always reagent oriented. Okay. Then breaking of sigma bond explains substitution reaction. Substitution reaction means a species is substituted by another similar kind of species. Means a nucleophile is substituted by a nucleophile. An electrophile is substituted by an electrophile. Okay, these are the examples of substitution reaction. Breaking of pi bond explains addition reaction. For example, RCl minus Cl minus plus OH minus ROH. It is an example of substitution reaction due to the breaking of sigma bond. Okay. CH2 double bond CH2 plus Cl2. Pi bond is broken to explain addition reaction. Here Cl minus is substituted by OH minus due to the breaking of sigma bond. Here pi bond is broken to get the addition product. These are the examples of addition reaction. This is an example of subscription layers. Okay. Now the mini reaction mechanism. Mini reaction mechanism. Now we are going to discuss the entire reaction mechanism of organic chemistry at a glance. At a glance. If you can understand this concept, then you can understand easily the 11th and 12th organic reactions concept for better understanding. Okay. Mini reaction mechanism. Organic compounds. Kind of reaction. And you should remember that alkene, that is saturated hydrocarbon, is called the root of organic chemistry. Root. And it is the most reduced form. And carboxylic acid is the most oxidized organic form of an organic compound. Hence, organic chemistry is started with alkene and ended in carboxylic acid. It is the burning case. It is a combustion case. Burning case is the saturated hydrocarbon, and a combustion case is a carboxylic acid. Okay. And in between alkenes and carboxylic acid, entire organic chemistry is there. Okay. First, alkenes. Only sigma bond. Hence, we can explain only substitution reaction. Okay. Alkenes and alkynes. These are the nucleophiles based on Lewis concept. Nucleophiles can attract electrophile. As pi bond is there, we can explain electromeric effect to break that pi bond. And breaking of pi bond explains addition reactions. As they are nucleophiles, they attract electrophiles for addition reaction. Electrophilic addition reaction. Generally, we can explain electrophilic addition reaction in case of alkenes and alkynes. Okay. Then benzene. Benzene is also a nucleophile. C double bond C. It also can attract an electrophile, but not for addition reaction, but for substitution reaction, because here pi bond is stable due to resonance. Hence, pi bond is not easily available for the addition reaction. As pi bond does not participate, sigma bond automatically participates. When sigma bond participates, it is an example of substitution reaction. Hence, the kind of reaction is SE, electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay. After benzene, then alkyl halide. Sigma one for substitution reaction. It is R plus, it is R minus due to the displacement of sigma one. X minus is the nucleophile. Substitution reaction takes place at sigma one. Hence, the kind of reaction is SN, nucleophilic substitution. Okay. Then, ARX. Aromatic AC. Then, ARCH2X. X is not attached to aromatic system. X is attached to aliphatic system like R. Like R. Hence the kind of reaction is SN. Like this. Like this. Okay. Then alcohol. Then alcohol. If this sigma bond is broken, it is RO minus H plus. It is Bronsted acid reaction. Bronsted acid reaction. To result salt. If this sigma bond is broken, then it is R plus, it is minus. SN, nucleophilic substitution reaction. OH minus is substituted by another nucleophile. Then AROH. If this bond is broken, it is ARO minus plus H plus. It is also Bronsted acid reaction. Bronsted acid reaction. If AROH as a whole is considered, it is an example of acid reaction like benzene. In later classes, we will discuss about the electrophilic substitution reaction on benzene nucleus. Here SC reaction takes place on benzene nucleus. Okay. After these compounds, ROR-, ether. Okay, sigma bond is broken to result R plus, R-O minus is the nucleophile which can be substituted. SN reaction. Okay, AR-OR, aromatic OR functional group is directly attached to the aromatic system. Hence, AC reaction takes place on benzene nucleus. Okay. Then after ether, aldehyde and ketone. Aldehyde ketones are the electrophiles. Hence, they can attract nucleophiles for addition reaction as pi bond is broken. Hence, the kind of reaction is nucleophilic addition. We can explain nucleophilic addition reaction in aldehydes and ketones. Aldehydes and ketones, due to the multiple bond with more electronegative atom, they are electrophiles. Electrophiles can attract nucleophile. Pi bond is broken for addition reaction. Then carboxylic acid. If this bond is broken, it is CO minus H plus. It is Bronsted acid reaction. If this bond is broken, then OH minus is the nucleophile. It is the example of SN reaction, sigma bond substitution reaction. Nucleophile is substituted. Hence, the kind of reaction is nucleophilic substitution reaction on carbon chain. Okay. Then C double bond OH. If pi bond is broken on carbonyl group, it is an example of nucleophilic addition reaction like this, but it is not reported because it is an example of electromeric effect, breaking of sigma bond. Examples of inductive effect dominates over electromeric effect because inductive effect is a permanent effect and electromeric effect is a temporary effect, and the permanent effect dominates over electromeric effect. Hence, nucleophilic addition reaction is not reported in carboxylic acids and its derivatives. Hope you are enjoying this video session. Be safe. Have a nice day.